Who closed that door? Hello, this is the RPG Chick. I'm with this Lunatory. Welcome to Let's Play the Darkside Detective. Starring Detective Francis McQueen. This will be a blind Let's Play, as most of mine are. Yeah. Gonna play through this, and then I'm gonna click to start. Now I got case files. This is interesting. Quits the game. The music seems a little loud, right? So, unfortunately, this resets every time when you quit the game and go back in. It doesn't remember the settings here. But police corruption is funny. On, you have on, still on. This is going nowhere. You should give up on this. And you don't learn, do you? Graphics have got high def, super high def, virtual reality, and spooky vision. And your machine can't run this. Let's set it on your machine can't run this. Now, how to play. Detective McQueen closes cases by talking to characters and solving puzzles. Left click to examine items or talk to characters. Left click on inventory items for more information. Drag items into the scene to use. Drag items onto each other to combine. They have combine. Right click to skip dialogue. Hint, McQueen can sometimes wear items. Your progress is auto-saved as you play. Please do not quit the game during a scene transition or your progress will may be lost. Credits, I don't see the use of doing that before the game's over. Unlock bonus cases, I don't know. Not for now. Twin Lakes Police System. So, this... I guess well, we already have bonus things unlocked. So, yeah, I guess we'll go into Malice and Wonderland. Now, the interesting thing is they kickstarted a sequel to this game, and it was funded, and that was a while ago. I think they're, like, well underway, and the game should be coming out in 2020, which at this time is next year. I can't believe 2020 is next year. That's insane. Anyway, Malice in Wonderland. Case summary. The chief has sent me to the Jones residence. Dooley is there with further details. Duly noted. Whoa! I almost shot you there, detective. You shouldn't be sneaking around like that. Dooley, you watched me drive up. I had my siren on. You waved at me as I pulled in. I guess this place has me spooked out a little. So, what happened here? Chief Scully just called me up and told me to get here ASAP. No details. Scully, huh? 7-year-old kid Alice went missing a day ago. No sign of her leaving the house. Seems to be the kind of spooky crap. I mean the kind of case you're into, Detective. Great. Let's get started. Squad car. Okay, so we can look, we can go inside, we can look, we can talk to him. Our trusty squad car. I like to call it the Popo Moto. Really? Myself? So what is this? Resume, restart options. So the options are the same as the sound effects and music. Okay. Alright. So there's really nothing much to look at here other than the squad car and Dooley. After you, detective. You know, whenever standing in this rain stops being fun for you. Alright, let's go in. Roy Jones. Officer Dooley, why is there a hobo dripping all over my carpet? That's Detective Francis McQueen, Mr. Jones. He's here to investigate. I see. Twin Lakes finest, eh? Whoa! These folks must be millionaires. Nice schooner. Haha! You dummy! It's not a schooner, it's a sailboat. A schooner is a sailboat, Dooley. on it. There. Ashtray. I hope you don't smoke around your kid. Thankfully, detective, I am rarely around my kid. Oh, nice. So, how can I help you, detective? Tell me about Alice. I'll level with you, detective. I don't have many dealings with her. She has a limited conversation pool. She's 7. Exactly. A tedious age, so I leave that to the nanny. She's around here somewhere. Where were you last night? How come you didn't notice she was missing? I was out. How wonderfully shady. Have you got an alibi? Where I was is none of your business, detective. My taxes pay your salary. They also pay for the cell and questioning room I'm going to have Dooley here take you to. Fine. Call this number. They'll vouch for me. Busty Bell's Booty Boutique. Classy stuff. Ah, Bell's. Fond memories. Huh? I mean, where was he? A bell shop? What? Right. I received an item. Matches. From the ashtray? Okay, I got matches. These are from Busty Bell. Oh, this is the... Okay, never mind the thing he gave me. Duh. These are from Busty Bell's Booty Boutique. This kid didn't win out on the father stakes. Yeah, really. I've taken up enough of your time. And I have nothing further to say, detective. Kindly leave me be. Jeez. Upstairs and hallway. Chandelier. One of those crystals is worth more than I get paid in a year. We could take one. You passed the corruption test? Well done, detective. This reminds me of my own grandfather. Your grandfather was a clock? What? No, he had a clock. Shame. I thought I'd finally found out something interesting about you. Huh. What? I'm interesting? Whatever you say, detective. Thanks. Closet, living room, study. So we came from the living room, right? Okay. Just want to make sure that's it's in the closet. Cobwebs. Box o' junk. A blacklight bulb. May as well take it. Now all we need is a disco ball, some white clothes, and fat beats. Then we've got ourselves a good night. A good night we'll be finding this kid. I received the blacklight bulb. A black light bulb for black lighting things. Oh no, not on my watch. Yeah, I can't combine that. All the other junk is useless junk. Yeah, we'll end up... Did you follow me into this closet? You may have needed backup? Yeah, we combine the black light bulb with the matches, we'll end up with a space... Time disturbance. Yeah, it's just not worth it. Does it seem odd to you that these folks don't have a kitchen or a bathroom? The recession hit us all hard, Dooley. Alright, the study. Locked. I wonder where I'd find a key. Seems like a bad idea to me. Alright, we're going to the stairs then. We can't, like, walk places, right? Oh, that's the closet. Never mind. Stop following me in there, Dooley. Let's go upstairs. Alright, we're gonna go to the attic. A place this fancy deserves something nicer than plastic flowers. Telephone. What an odd place for a telephone. They must have run out of places to draw. I mean, put it. Breaking the fourth wall already, Dooley. That's pretty early. So downstairs. master bedroom and daughter's bedroom. Let's check the master bedroom first, just because... Oh, there's a person. Oh, there's a nanny in there. Poor woman must be worried sick about her kid. We'll find her, detective. That nanny is beautiful. Ask her if she's single. You know, as part of the investigation. Tell me about Alice. She's boiled and sticks her nose where it doesn't belong. But that's what having super rich parents will do to you, I guess. What's a nanny doing in the master bedroom? Nanny McQueen. Okay, she's a fiend. Nothing suspicious, that's for sure. No siree. How long have you've been working for the Joneses? Oh, I did it right, too. He said Jones. Jones is detective. Even though it ends with an S, you still pluralize it. Is now really the best time? It's always a good time for grammar. Anyway, answer the question. Long enough to harbor no ill will whatsoever. Oh, really? You're a little obvious, aren't you? Say, you're the nanny. The very innocent nanny, yes. Do you have keys for the various rooms? I'm a nanny, not a maid. Right, but do you? Yes. May I have the key to the study, then? Sure. There's nothing incriminating in there anyway. I received the study key. Okay. We're done here, for now. I'll get back to work, and nothing else. Study key. This should unlock the study for me. Family photo. Alice and her mom look quite happy here. Drawers. Seems impolite to go rifling around in somebody's drawers uninvited. I thought the second drawer would have something else. Bed? A water bed. Very fancy. Looks like something has been kicked under here. No, it doesn't. It does! It's a strange page. Anything else? Nothing else under there. Alright. Strange page. It's a peculiar pattern from the Occult for Dummies book. You know anything about this page? Recognize this? That? Oh, no. I'm more of a complete idiot's guide kind of gal. Do you like this black light bulb? That's a rookie mistake. That's some matches. That's where Mr. Jones hired me. What of it? Seriously, I was just randomly doing this. Alright. I wonder if he has anything to say about this stuff then. Officer Dooley. Rookie mistake. Alright, so daughter's bedroom. Oh, that's the wife in there. Teddy? Tell me where she is, bear! I'm only kidding. You don't know. You're only a bear. A stupid, know-nothing bear. I was waiting for the thing to start talking. Man, this could be a drawing of our suspect. Really? I'll put it on APB then. No, Dooley, don't do that. I've never seen a horse with five legs before. You sure that's a leg? Huh. Tree. Looking at this, I doubt she's going to art school. Oh, that's really sensitive. Pens. This is no time for art, detective. Blacklight. This looks useful. Okay, now I have a blacklight marker. The label says for use under blacklight. I think I need more than one. Drawers? I don't have that much use for a dozen pink socks. Alright, Mrs. Jones? Hello, can I ask? My baby! My baby is gone! Can you tell me about Alice? She just disappeared, my baby! Is there anything? You have to find her. Goodbye. Find her. Okay. What do you know about this blacklight marker? What do you know about this weird page? See if she'd react to any of this stuff. Nope. Oh, I showed her the thing, okay? That beast. I knew he was up to no good. Yes, as I know. Black light marker? Okay. What do you have to say about the demon thing? Alright, let's go. Wait, does he have anything to say in here, Dooley? This is a lot of pink. I think I'd have run off too. I just had to see. Alright, so let's see if he has anything to say about any of this stuff. The blacklight bulb. Found your study key. You'll be glad to know I found the key to your study. Good. Hopefully you'll be as successful in finding my daughter. See? He does care. My wife's constant wailing is getting on my nerves. Oh. Have you ever seen this, Mr. Jones? Okay. Alright, the study is here. Locked. I wonder if we can use this key. And hey, presto, we're in. What does Dooley have to say now? You never trust a man who has too many books, that's what I say. How many books are too many? 6? And how many books do you own? I don't feel comfortable with this line of questioning. Guessing 0. Okay, I can't look at the picture of him for some reason. Lantern? An old oil lantern. Seems to have some oil left, too. Yoink! Yoink! Receive the lantern. And he says the same exact thing. Dog statue. The statue is ugly enough to be worth a lot of cash. Bookshelf. Oh, magazine stack as well. A nice collection of books. The dust suggests they've not been looked at in some time. A shame. His magazine collection. Jeez. This guy is obsessed with jugs. Jugs. I had a feeling it was going to be something like that. Another lovely pair. Right. It just goes... Okay. Armchair. Hey, there are only 2 seats in this house. Don't be daft, Dooley. There are more. They're just off camera. Off camera, huh? What do you think about this lantern? Oh, now I can look at... I couldn't look at the painting before. Nothing showed up. Alright. Roy Jones, Esquire. It takes a certain type of person to have an oil painting of themselves. What if I hold up the black light to this? Seems like a bad idea. What if I put a marker on it? I'm tempted to write Roy is a jerk on the painting in blacklight marker, but I'm too much of a pro for that. Yeah, you'll say ass instead. Alright. What if I put the blacklight bulb in the chandelier? I can't help but think this cheap blacklight would look out of place in their fancy chandelier. I don't give a crap. You think about this lantern? No. What if I put the black light bulb in the lantern? Can I? No. I could draw us onto the boat, but I don't see the point. Right on him, though. This isn't. Alright, let's go back upstairs then. Oh, we haven't gone to the attic yet, that's right. Paint thinner. The paint thinner fell when the shelf gave away. Not much left in it now. But yet I have some of it. Dissolves paint, markers, and oily residues. Okay. So I have a blacklight marker, which I can use and then show off with the blacklight bulb, and then I have this paint thinner, which I can use to dissolve the blacklight marker. Boxes. A box marked Anne's Broken Dreams. Oh boy. As attics go, this one is extra creepy. Those look heavy enough to knock somebody out cold. Paint cans. There's a lot of stuff in here. Broken lamp? May not be broken after all. Just a blown bulb. I wonder what we can put in it. Broken shelf. Looks like this gave way recently, spilling paint thinner all over the wall. Just a bunch of forgotten memories. I meant to drag it. I hope that doesn't reveal somebody's attic shame. What the heck? Well, that doesn't look ominous at all. Dark side doorway. Cool. It's a cool theme. The pattern on the wall looks washed out in places. I wonder what would happen if I redrew it. Really? You really want to redraw this thing? Okay then. I meant to drag it. Okay, I seem to have everything I need. Let's just get down to some spooky hijinks and redraw these missing symbols. Oh, brother. These are that's a graphic pipe thing from ASCII, extended ASCII characters. Just checking these to make sure these all work. Okay. So, where are we here? Are we doing this one? Because then this would be... see really any of this music is very distracting. Okay, something. Oh, listen to that. Is this a combination of something? Let's put this one here then. Can I drag other ones off? No. This. Oh, that one's... You know what? It's funny. I kept looking at that and not realizing the symbol's already there. Never mind, guys. That should be it. Great. Maybe now is a good time to stop doing, well... anything, really. I wonder if I can file for early retirement? Even I'm not foolish enough to go in there with no light. That would be more useful if it was lit, okay. I should probably light this thing, you know, just in case. You received a lit lantern. One light-emitting lantern. Okay, Dooley, let's do this. No offense, Detective, but I'm going nowhere near that creep fast. I'll, stand guard out here. Okay. Is this the little girl? Let me look at everything else first. I shouldn't leave without Alice. A box marked Baby's First Cult Robes. Really now? The label says Old Milk, circa 1880. Why would you store that? No one else says that, okay. Pile of junk? Don't look in there, mister. That's where the three-eyed rats hide. Oh, okay. Three-eyed rats. Understood. Paint thinner. Oh, hello there, Alice, then. Hello, mister. Hey, kiddo. Are you here to take me home? Yep. Good. I'm hungry and the sounds from downstairs are scaring me. Yeah, let's get out of here. Crash bang. Not so fast, detective. It's Nanny McFiend. Where's Dooley? That idiot? I knocked him out. I can't have you snooping around anymore, so I'm going to trap you here. Let me guess, she used the paint cans. At least take the girl. Oh, I intend to. I'm her legal guardian, after all. It's my job to look after her, especially if anything should happen to her parents. Say, for example, getting trapped in the Darkside's version of their bedroom? That's what this is? An inheritance scheme? You have to admit, it's a fairly perfect crime. It is, actually. So even if you do get rid of me, then what? Alice knows what you're up to. She's a smart kid. If she's so smart, she'll know to keep her mouth shut. Once Dooley wakes up, you and your scheme will be done for. Good point. I'll just have to get you to drag him in here with you. I'll just have to get you to drag him into here without... with you. I'll just have to get you to drag him into here with you. Come on. Oh, okay. That's a very awkward sentence. Ah, Dooley out cold. Don't waste time trying to sweet-talk your way out of this. I'm scared, mister. It'll all be okay. I knew those paint buckets were heavy enough to knock someone out. Yeah, really. Oh, I know what to do. Bye, lady. Have a taste of your own medicine. No! Well, that's... that problem's solvent. Come on, Alice. Let's wake up Dooley so I can tell him my pun. Pretend it's the first time you heard it, okay? Okay, mister. So the kid got into the nanny's stuff and accidentally used it to trap herself in that creepy attic? The dark side. But that's a surprisingly useful summary of things, yes. Shame the nanny was certifiable. She was a looker. Dooley, she was dabbling in the dark arts. With the plan to trap innocent people in a parallel world. Kidnap their kid, and steal all their cash. I said it was a shame, geez. I wonder where the nanny got the occult books from, anyway. That stuff is hard to find these days. A case for another day, I guess. First of all, I have to figure out what kind of paperwork covers this mess. Case closed. Solved. Okay. Well, thanks for watching, guys. I guess we'll tune out here. It's kind of a shortish episode for me, but seems like a good place to leave things off, and I'll see you tomorrow with the next case file, Tome Alone. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.